The opposing side, Steve Voshall.
I'm really excited to see this many people here. I have a lot of meetings, and we have all of our Tea Party meetings here. And this is the biggest crowd that I've seen in a GOP meeting or a Tea Party meeting. But let me thank a few people first. Thank you, Brad, for putting this together, and the GOP for putting this together. I am Steve Voshall. I'm the chairman, founder of the Forsyth County Tea Party. And I'm joined here tonight with Tony DeMaria, who is with Citizens for Responsible Growth. And I'm honored to speak on behalf of this issue. I've put a lot of time into this issue. I've done a lot of research, probably more than I had initially thought I would have to put into it. But I've kind of become the expert on it. So as everyone seems to know, except our county commissioners, we are in the midst of one of the worst recessions since the 1930s. We are in a double-dip recession. Families in this county are hurting. In our county, we have over 9% unemployment. Homeowners' equity is down $3.8 billion since 2007. Housing starts have dropped 96% since 2006. And the economic activity it generated has plummeted. We are experiencing record-high home foreclosures and runaway inflation. And analysts do not see an end to this until late 2014. In light of this, our elected officials have raised our property taxes, increased our school millage rates, added a new school SPLOST. Now the county is asking for another $200 million in SPLOST 7. Next year, the state will ask for billions of dollars in the T-SPLOST. And in all likelihood, commissioners will raise our property taxes again next year. So that's six new or extended taxes in 24 months. All these taxes in what is supposed to be the second most conservative county in the country. For our family's sake and for sake of our own economic survival, at some point we must say no, and this is the time to do so. The Tea Party has been described by many as the party of no. We are not the party of no, we're just very, very focused on our three core principles: fiscal responsibility, constitutionally limited government, and free markets. Sadly, there are just many, many things in our government that causes us to stand up and say no. These are the same old and common sense values that we have that our founding fathers fought for. We can't say we are fiscally responsible Republicans at the federal level, but then allow and support our local and state elected officials to spend like big government politicians. We all know the importance of the presidential election, but even if we elect a new president, and in my estimation, an entirely new Congress, we will not fix this problem long term. We must realize that the state and local officials are the minor league for the federal government. In order for us to fix the federal level, federal issues at the federal government level, we must first fix it at this local and state levels. Thankfully, we are not the only citizen group who has researched and is opposing SPLOST. Other groups and leaders like Trilby Leach of the Concerned Citizens of Forsyth, Bill Evelyn of the State of Georgia Tea Party, Tony DeMaria of Citizens for Responsible Growth, and Hugh Shashi of the Net News Network are also working hard to defeat this tax. Why do so many of us oppose this tax? First and most importantly, the SPLOST is a tax. SPLOST 7 is not about the jail, it's about yet another tax for six more years. It takes $20 billion of sales to generate $200 million in sales revenue. It is very important to know that if these projects are not completed due to the economy and low sales revenues, these projects must still be completed. They can be downsized, but they must be completed with revenues out of the county's general funds or from yet another SPLOST. Our issue is with the timing of the SPLOST, the state of the economy, the special referendum ballot, the approximately $50 million for a new courthouse, the destroying of the city skyline with this huge jail they just showed us, the parking lot and courthouse, and the fact that the new jail will not meet our needs after 2023. Based upon the county's own numbers, the inmate population will exceed this new jail in the year 2023, and on that finite piece of property, we cannot expand it any further. To adequately do a jail this size, we need it on at least 10 acres plus so that we can double it again in 20 years. Well, tonight you're going to hear the supporters say that this is not a new tax, it's just an extension of one, and they're right, but it is still a tax. The SPLOST 7 is a tax and comes out of your family's income and budget. A 1% tax will cost your household about $3,100 over 6 years. That's about $500 a year from your family's budget transferred to the county's budget. And remember, we have only three, we could have three separate SPLOSTs on the books by 2013. you could have over $9,000 taken out of your family's budget and transferred to other taxing institutions. So have you ever experienced, have you ever asked yourself why the, since 1983, why has an expiring SPLOST in this county never not been followed by yet another SPLOST? I was appalled to read where Mr. Seago said one of the main reasons we must pass this tax is because the county's budget is so strained. By a show of hands, how many of you in the audience today feel like your family's budget is strained? Thank you. Mr. Seago, these are the people and thousands just like them in Forsyth County who we are trying to fight for to oppose this tax. Another reason we oppose this tax is because the citizens have been left out of the decision-making process. We've had practically no public meetings on SPLOST 7. You referenced 14 meetings. Only one of those has been a town hall meeting on July 21st. The rest of them were either board meetings or work sessions where we're not permitted to have any input. The county has more meetings and gives out more information for a simple rezoning on a parcel of land or a red light than we have had on a $200 million future tax. We have asked why the land in the county bought for $7 million in 2008, why it's no longer buildable, which we built for the jail. We have asked to see what it would take to enlarge our current courthouse out the backside and out the, on the sides where the trailers are at, so that we can expand, add two courtrooms, inmate holding cells, secured parking for judges, a secured elevator for inmate and judge use. We've also made suggestions to move the tag office out of Sony Center, which we own, and to move the probate court and all their employees into Sony Center. We have also suggested that an efficiency study be done on our court system and its processes to suggest areas where we could save time and money. When we finally had a town hall meeting last week after early voting had already started, we were finally able to see this picture here, and we were appalled to see how large the jail, courthouse, and parking deck will look in our city. It was shocking, it was huge, and it was ugly. Several years ago, several hundred business owners like myself participated in the Chamber's 2020 vision plan. We put many, many hours into meetings on what we wanted our city to look like in the future, and that was most definitely not it. One of the biggest issues we have on this SPLOST is that they are trying to cram a huge jail onto a small, finite piece of property downtown. Not only will it ruin the skyline, but it will be out of date after we hit 1,300 inmates, even with the addition that they show there in gray, which will be estimated by their own numbers in the year 2023. Tonight, the commissioners, through their surrogates, will tell you that over 38% of the revenue comes from outside the county. I find this incredibly hard to believe. When I'm stuck on 400 heading southbound, there aren't very many cars coming up this way. When I'm stuck in 400 heading northbound, coming home in the northbound, there aren't very many heading south. So they've all got malls in their counties. They've all got shops in their counties. I don't think they're saying at night with their wives, hey, let's drive to Forsyth and have dinner. I find that hard to believe. Certainly some numbers true, but not 38%. You will also hear from Mr. Seago and his supporters how this prison will pay for itself in just 10 years. It's on their website. Now, you don't have to be a rocket scientist to figure out that if we're spending $2 million a year over 10 years, it's not going to add up to be $100 million. When asked where those figures came from, he said it came from the sheriff, the same sheriff whose budget is 20% more than Hall County and Cherokee County sheriff's budgets, even though they have more deputies and have a larger landmass. Last, we oppose this tax because we will not stand for the scare tactics the commissioners and their surrogates are using to get their way on this SPLOST. The website says that if we don't pass SPLOST, they will be forced to raise property taxes, and that a judge will force us to build a jail. Does that sound familiar to anyone? Is this similar threat to what we got from the school system back when we passed the school SPLOST, only to have them raise the millage rates? So don't be fooled again. Thank you.
Steve
Ocean. Let me just respond quickly to the last question as far as the Fulton County. Fulton County had 3,000 prisoners sleeping on the floor for many, many months on end, and had been warned by a judge previously that if they didn't enter into a contract for additional jail space, that he was going to take it to court. We have our prisoners in beds in prisons. Okay, many other counties around us went out and built big prisons, and they didn't have the prisoners to fill it in. And then they hit the double dip recession we're in, and that's why the rates come down. They're wanting us to put our prisoners there. That's why it's lowered. Now, at some point, we're going to have to move our prisoners out of there because they're going to, you know, need that for their own prisoners. But my closing statement, you know, when county commissioners campaign for office, they all promise to be good stewards of our taxpayer dollars. But in the past year, these commissioners have voted to give our county manager a 22% raise, increase their own health care benefits after they leave office to age 65, to give $700,000 of the taxpayer money to a private company, to give the county banking contract to a bank, which was not the lowest bidder, and now, of course, they're pushing hard for this $200 million SPLOST VII tax. If that's their idea of good money management, please stop. Can we afford it? We must remember, what started out as a SPLOST in our county in 1983 or 84 as a well-intended special purpose local option sales tax has turned into a continuous big government dependency tax program that our elected officials cannot let go of. The time is now to put a stop to this continuation of SPLOST and to demand open government and citizen involvement in any future programs. Please vote no on November 8th.